On Rival 600, the thing that we really wanted to look at was when you lift off your mouse to put it back again somewhere. You always do this because you need to do swipes, you need to move around on the screen, all that stuff. We wanted to combat that inconsistency. Obviously, we all have a navigational sensor in there. Navigational sensor is what picks up the motion of the mouse. Then we translate that into something that moves your cursor or your person on the screen or whatever. That's one sensor that sits in there. What happens when you do a vertical lift is that for a period of time, your regular navigational sensor will be a little bit confused. It won't know what's going on, essentially. It doesn't know whether it's just it stopped tracking because the mouse pad was out or whatever happened. The way that we're helping the regular navigational sensor is we've added an additional sensor that does nothing else but track liftoff. Then it tells the navigational sensor to shut off. You don't have to work anymore. It's very simple. And this little sensor we've placed in there has nothing else to do in the world than just track the distance. So it means that we can be a lot more precise. It's less than 0.5 millimeters. That's less than a credit card. It's super, super thin. So you're not getting all the wobble, you're not getting all the inconsistencies. You're just getting a nice, clean signal. When you're designing a new mouse, you have obviously a thousand elements to consider, but one of the most important things is how you capture and translate your hand movement with perfect fidelity. We're always looking for how we can make the gaming experience better for the gamer.